teacher for today. What we have here are intended learning outcomes. First, you have to identify the famous Filipino painters and composers. Second, interpret one of the artwork or music made by the famous Filipino painters and composers provided. And lastly, illustrate the importance of the contribution of the famous Filipino painters and composers. But before we start our activity for today, I want you to name one of your favorite painting made by a famous Filipino painter or a music made or composed by a famous Filipino composer. So you can share it down below, comment it, and share to us what's your reason why it is your favorite. Done? Now let's proceed. I want you to be energized first before we start our discussion for the day. So let us all sing the song, we call it Art.
Let's paint with some colors. Start with yellow, red, and blue. Mix them together to get purple, green, and orange too. We put the paint on the brush and we swirl it all around. We swirl it all around on the canvas. We call it art.
Developing activity for our discussion, I have here a game. So you just need to identify whose picture of the famous Filipino painter or composer is being presented by choosing the right letter of the name, or it could be whose artwork the picture belonged to. So I have here a presentation. Now let's start guessing. Thank you. I hope you have a lot of correct answers just by guessing. Now let's proceed. Here are the list of the famous Filipino painters. from Fernando Cueto Amorsolo, Carlos Modesto Villalos, and so on. So we will discuss it one by one. He is Fernando Cueto Amorsolo, born on May 30, 1892, and died on April 24, 1972. He's a National Artist Awardee in the year 1972, and he reaped various honors in his golden years. He's often known as a grand old man of the Philippine art, and he exhibited 40 of his genres and landscapes at the Art Center of New York in the year 1925. He is popularly known for his craftsmanship and mastering the use of light. He painted at the Polo, Under Tree, Afternoon Meal of the Rice Workers, The Blind Man, The Burning of Manila, Dalagang Bukid, Maiden in a Stream, Planting Rice, The Mestiza, and many more. And he was the director of the School of Fine Arts of the University of the Philippines. So here are his artworks. Observe. Next, we have here Carlos Modesto Villaluz Botong Francisco, or Botong Francisco. He was born on November 4, 1912, and died on March 31, 1969. He was the most distinguished practitioner of mural painting for many decades, and best known for his historical pieces. He was also one of the first Filipino modernists, breaking away from the romanticism of Amorsolo, to make use of geometric forms and linear painting. In his paintings, he featured Filipinos living in the provincial towns and barrios. He also painted vital events in the Philippine history. He painted Kaingin, which he won the first prize at the competition of the Art Association of the Philippines in the year 1948. He also painted the mural titled Filipino Struggle Through History, a mural gracing walls of Manila City Hall. He painted the first mast at Limasawa in the year 1965, the progress of medicine in the Philippines in the year 1953, and a lot more. So here are some pieces that is painted by Botong Francisco. Next, we have here Victoria Edades. He is counted as one of the revolutionary 13 moderns and later called the father of the modern Philippine painting. His works employed dark and somber colors and were focused on depicting the dirt and sweats of laborers, factory workers, and the Philippine proletariat. He painted Portrait of the Professor in the year 1927, The Sketch in the year 1982, Mother and Daughter in the year 1926. So he was the opposite of the lively colors from the artworks of Amorsolo. So here are his some of his artworks. Next, we have Vicente Selva Manansala. His canvases were described as masterpieces that brought the culture of the barrio and the city together. He is a National Artist Award in the year 1981. He popularized neo-realism in the country and developed a style called transparent cubism, where he masterfully overlaid colors and shapes to depict forms and figures. His Madonna of the Slums in the year 1950 is a portrayal of a mother and a child from the countryside who became urban shanty residents once in the city. In his Jeepneys in the year 1951, he combined the elements of provincial folk culture with the congestion issues of the city. While his painting gave you this diary, a glimpse of his kind of cubism, in which some sides of the objects are sharply cut into curved or angular form to catch the light vibrantly. And he also painted Kalabaw or Carabao in the year 1965. So here are some of his artworks. Next, we have here Mias Elizalde Navarro. He is a versatile artist being both a proficient painter and sculptor. Three of his major mixed media works are I'm Sorry Jesus, I Can't Attend Christmas This Year, and his homage to Dudley Laurel, and a flying contraption for Mr. Icarus. He did Manila Chronicle and the Rotund India Ink figurative drawings for Lydia Aguila's storybook Huwantamad, and he is also the National Artist for Visual Arts in the year 1999. Here are some of his artworks. Next, we have Ang Kyohok. He is born to immigrant Chinese parents, Vicente Ang and Chin Lim. He is one of the most vital and dynamic figures as one of those who came at the heels of the pioneering modernists during that decade. He blazed a formal and iconographic path of his own through expressionistic works of high visual impact and compelling meaning. He crystallized in vivid cubistic figures and terror and angst of the times, shaped in the foreignness of the political turmoil of those times. Some of his works include Geometric Landscape, Pieta, which won for him the bronze medal in the first international art exhibition held in Saigon in the year 1962, and A Seated Figure in the 1979 auctioned at Sotheby's in Singapore. He is also a National Artist for Visual Arts in the year 2001. His works can be found in many major art collections, among them the Cultural Center of the Philippines, National Historical Museum of Taipei, and the National Museum in Singapore. So here are some of his artworks. Next, we have Osit D. Hoya. He is the creator of the compositions that were described as vigorous compositions, of heavy impastos, bold brush strokes, controlled dips, and diagonal stripes. He applied paint thinly on his canvas. That form grew increasingly geometric with circles as the main motifs. He liked to add brilliant tropical colors. He was awarded a Fulbright Smile Mondrian, which enabled him to pursue a master's degree in fine arts in the year 1956 to 1957. And he is also a national artist in the year 2003. Here are some of his artworks. Now we have Felix Resurreccion Hidalgo. He is acknowledged as one of the great Filipino painters of the late 19th century. He won a silver medal for his entry in large canvas entitled Christian Virgins Exposed to the Populace, or Las Virginis Cristianas Expuestas al Populacion, at the Madrid Exposition of Fine Arts. He painted Charon's Boat, Oedipus, and Antigone when he was residing in Paris. His sunrise in the year 1985 revealed his ingenuity in painting landscape and seascapes. He also painted artist mother, one of the two portraits he did for his mother in Paris. So here are some of his artworks. Now we have the very famous Juan Luna Inovicio, or just Juan Luna, our brother of Antonio Luna, a painter, sculptor, and a political activist of the Philippine Revolution during the late 19th century. He became one of the first recognized Philippine artists. He painted the death of Cleopatra and Spolarium. Luna had created the Spolarium, which won one of the several gold medals at the Exposition Nacional de Bellas Artes. He painted the Dream of Love, Tampuhan, the Lady with Guitar, and Houses by a Narrow Road. Here are some of his paintings. Next, we have Mauro Malang Santos. He was an illustrator, cartoonist for the Manila Chronicle, and creator of comic strip Cosme the Cap and Chain Gang Chronicle. In the year 1960s, he emerged as a serious artist with a knack in abstract painting. His illustration style is enumeration of the images, ranges of warm color, and evocation of Jewish parochialism. So here are some of his artworks. Next, we have Cesar Legazpi. He was a national artist. His works described as depiction of anguish and the humanization of beggars and laborers in the city. He painted Man and Woman in the year 1985, Gadgets in the year 1947. So here are some of his artworks. So we have here The Workers, Comancheros, and Sea of Gold. Next artist, we have here Hernando Campo, a member of the 13 Moderns, one of the leading radical modernist artists in the country. He originally studied law before moving into the visual arts. He painted Genesis in the year 1985, Man and Carabao in the year 1965, and Two Fish in 1951. Here are some of his artworks. Next, we have Arturo R. Luz. He's a National Artist Award in Visual Arts in the year 1997. He is also known as a printmaker, sculptor, designer, and art administrator. He painted the Handel Vendors in the year 1952 to 1954, Bagong Taon in the year 1997, Cities of the Past in the year 1999. So here are some of his artworks. Now we have here the only lady in our list, Anita Magsaysay Ho, best known for her social realist and post-Cubism portrayals of Filipino life and culture, notably and frequently portraying groups of women engaged in labor. She studied under Fernando Amorsolo at the University of the Philippines School of Fine Arts before moving to the United States to study at the Cranbrook Academy in Michigan. Her work centered on the central tenets of modernism, garnering her inclusion in the Filipino artist group, the 13 Moderns, the only woman to do so. Anita Magsaysay Ho received significant critical acclaim and recognition for her work before her death, including first prize at the Philippine Art Association in the year 1952. Her work can be found among the collections of institutions like the Metropolitan Museum of Manila and Ateneo Art Gallery in Manila, Philippines. Here are some of her artworks. So as you can see a lot of women working. So for example, women in basket, now we are done with the famous Filipino painters. Let's proceed with the famous Filipino composers. We have here Antonio Molina, Colonel Antonio Benaventura, and so on. Antonio Molina, a composer, conductor, and music administrator. He was also a national artist in music in the year 1973. He was known to as the Claude Debussy of the Philippines due to his use of impressionism in music. He composed the zarzuela Ate Maria and Hating Gabi. He is also the conductor of the Montserrat Philharmonic Band, the Yellow Taxi Orchestra, and Rondalia, and the operas Madame Butterfly, La Gioconda, La Fuerza del Destino, and Cavilla Rusticana. So let us hear his Hating Gabi. Here, Colonel Antonio Benaventura. He was a national artist for music in the year 1988, a renowned composer, conductor, and a teacher. He restored the Philippine Constabulary Band, now Philippine Army Band. He composed short piano pieces, hymns and songs, pieces for band, chamber music, chorus and orchestra, music pieces, and theater music. Next, we have here Lucretia Roses Casilag, a noted composer, educator, cultural and arts administrator, and performing artist. She was named National Artist for Music in the year 1989. She pioneered the fusion of the Filipino ethnic and Western music. She dared to mix indigenous Filipino instruments with Western orchestra in her prize-winning Toccata for Percussion and the Winds, Divertissement and Concertante, and scores of the Filia Shana, Misang Filipino, and the Profundes. She was fondly called Tita King. So let us hear her composition. Next, we have Lucio D. San Pedro. He composed the popular lullaby, Sa Ugoy ng Duyan, in collaboration with Livy Silerio, and the symphonic poem, Lahing Kayo Manggi. He was the conductor of the Musical Philippines Philharmonic Orchestra. He was connected with the major conservatories in the country and wrote sacred and secular vocal music, overtures, tunes, poems, symphonic poems, and quartets. Next, we have Livy Silerio, a prolific lyricist and composer of decades. He effortlessly translated or wrote anew the lyrics to traditional melodies, such as O Maliwanag na Buwan in Iloco, Ako ay May Singsing in Pampanggenyo, Alibangbang in Visaya, and among others. He was born in Tondo. He received his scholarship at the Academy of Music in Manila. That made it possible for him to join the Manila Symphony Orchestra, becoming its youngest member. He made it to the Guinness Book of World Records as the only person able to make music using just a leaf. He has also a great number of his songs have been written for the local movies, which earned him the Lifetime Achievement Award from the Film Academy of the Philippines. He has enriched the Philippine music for no less than two generations. With a treasury of more than 4,000 songs, in an idiom that has proven to appeal to all his social classes. So let us hear one of his compositions. Composer, musicologist, teacher, and performer. He explored the musicality of the Filipino deeply. He embarked on a lifelong dedication to the understanding and popularization of Filipino traditional music. His researches and fieldwork have resulted in the collection of an immense number of recorded music taken from the remotest mountain villages and farthest island communities. He wrote papers that enlightened scholars, both Filipino and foreign, about the nature of Philippine traditional and ethnic music. Usually performed as the communal ritual, his composition like Ugma Ugma in the year 1963, Pagsamba in the year 1968, and Udlot Udlot in the year 1975 are monuments to Philippine music. Next, we have here Hernani Huson Cuenco, a Filipino composer, film scorer, musical director, music teacher, and Philippine national artist for music. He wrote an outstanding and memorable body of works that resonate with the Filipino sense of musicality and which embody an ingenious voice that raises the aesthetic dimension of contemporary Filipino music. He played with the Philippine Youth Symphony Orchestra and the Manila Symphony Orchestra from year 1960 to 1968, and the Manila Chamber Soloist from 1966 to 1970. He completed a music degree in piano and cello from the University of Santo Tomas, where he also taught for decades. He was proclaimed National Artist for Music in the year 1997. His songwriting credits include Nahan Kahit na Magtiis, and Diligin Mo ang Hamog ang Uhaw na Lupa, Pilipinas, Inang Bayan, Isang Dalangin, Kalesa, Bato sa Buhangin, and Gaano Ko Ikaw Kamahal. The latter song shows how Cuenco enriched the Filipino love ballad by adding the elements of condiment to it.
Thank you.
have here Dr. Francisco F. Feliciano. He created more than 30 major works that include operas and music dramas, including La Loba Negra, Ashen Wings, Sikhay sa Kabila ng Paalam, or Beyond the Farewell, and The Life of Wartime, Filipino Hero, Jose Abad Santos. Among his large works are Transfiguration and Mesa Mysterium for orchestra and large chorus, the ballet Yerma, and several prize-winning compositions including Pokpok Alempako, a favorite piece of choirs and international choral competitions, and Salimbayan, Umiinong, Walang Tinag, was premiered in New York City at the ISCM Festival. In the year 1977, Dr. Feliciano was given a John D. Rockefeller III Award in Music Composition. He composed hundreds of liturgical pieces, mass settings, hymns, and songs for worship at the Asian Institute for Liturgy and Music. He is also devoted to the promotion of Asian music and arts. Its goals is to put music and art in the context of worship. Next, we have here Ramon Pagayon Santos, a composer, conductor, and musicologist, is currently the country's foremost exponent of contemporary Filipino music. He graduated in year 1965 from the UP College of Music with a teacher's diploma and a Bachelor of Music degree in both composition and conducting. His compositional style shifted to neoclassicism and finally to a distinct merging of a varied influences that he had assimilated abroad. He did more orthodox performances, modes, chamber works, and multimedia works for dance and theater. Managhoy in the year 1984 for reader, voices, gongs and bass drum, and the poetry of Benigno Aquino Jr. An intense and avid pedagogue, Santos, as chair of the Department of Composition and Theory of the College of Music, UP, has remained instrumental in his voicing modern Philippine music rooted in old Asian practices and life concepts. Ryan Cayabyab, the most accomplished composer, arranger, and musical director in the Philippine music industry since his blooming beginnings in the year 1970s. His learned, skillful, and versatile music styles span a wide range of genres, from conservatory or art compositions such as concert religious music, symphonic work, art song, opera, and concerto to mainstream popular idioms in the music industry and in live contemporary multimedia shows such as musical theater, dance, and film. Being very visible in the national media, once a TV host, Cayabyab is a household name. I know you already know him. His compositions reflect a perspective of music that extols the exuberance of life and human happiness, thus capturing the very essence of our Filipino soul.
The coconut nut is a giant nut. If you eat too much, you get very fat. Now, the coconut nut is a big, big nut, but this delicious nut is not a nut. It's the cocoa fruit.
It's the cocoa fruit
of the cocoa tree.
Of the cocoa tree.
From the cocoa palm family.
I have here some questions. Number one, who are the famous Filipino painters? Name them with their artworks. Number two, who are the famous Filipino composers? Name them with some of their music. Number three, if you will be the one of the famous Filipino painters or composers, what would be your subject or music all about? Number four, as a student, why do we need to know and learn about the famous Filipino painters and composers? Number five, what is the importance of the contribution of the different famous Filipino painters and composers? And last number, if you know other famous Filipino painters and composers that are not mentioned, name them and share them with the class. You can comment down below your answers for this part. Based on the presentation of the different famous Filipino painters and composers, select one artwork or music made by the famous Filipino painter and composer, and then interpret the meaning of that certain artwork or music based on your perspective or understanding. Write one paragraph about your interpretations. For your assessment, I will provide a downloadable document. For activity 1, identification, identify the famous Filipino painter or composer being described in the sentence. So you can write your answers on the space provided. For activity number 2, illustrate, draw a poster that shows the importance of the contribution of the famous Filipino painters and composers. Draw it on a short bond paper. That's the end of our discussion. If you have some questions or clarifications, you can comment down below or message me on Facebook. Thank you.